jeans and curly hair. Man. No, it's a really good point. I think there's, listen up, this is my last point tonight. There's so many good things that you can talk about with this youth group, with this church, with your Savior, okay? You don't need to lie. Don't lie. It's going to hurt you. I just want to read a quick passage for you, going with this quality over quantity thing. I really believe, and I think the book of Mark tells us this, is that we need to understand that more importantly than numbers, we need to worry about ourselves, and we need to worry about our relationship with each other. I'm going to read this real quick. It says in chapter 11 of Mark, verse 22, "Have faith in God," Jesus answered. "I tell you the truth, if anyone says to this mountain, 'Go throw yourself into the sea,' and does not doubt it in his heart, but believes that what he says will happen, it will be done for him." It's pretty heavy. "Therefore I tell you, whatever you ask for in prayer, believe that you have received it, and it will be yours." Okay, that's the first thing I want you to get out of this. Prayer works. Prayer is good. Okay, this is really important too. "And when you stand praying, if you hold anything against anyone," what should you do?
Forgive
him, so that your Father in heaven may forgive you of your sins. What's Jesus saying here? Jesus is saying here, okay, you need to forgive people because there's a good chance that people need to forgive you. Do you understand that? Okay, so often we love to not let things go. We like just to leave things left undone. It happens in this youth group all the time. It's worse at your school. I don't know how your family life is, but there's just little bickering that happens. And you might not think it's a big deal, but it accumulates. And then it accumulates some more. I'm not trying to point any fingers, but it happens all the time. It used to happen a lot more in this youth group, and I'm really glad that a lot of you are maturing in those ways. And I think that's cool. Okay? Forgive each other. I'm telling you right now, God will not use us if this youth group is divided. Okay? But if we're together, if we're strong as one youth group, leading and trying to serve Christ, a lot of great things can happen. Do you understand that? We are so strong when we're together as one. That's why the book of Ephesians, Paul writes, "Be one in Christ. Stand together. We're so strong together. But if we're apart, if we're bickering, if we're refusing to love each other, refusing to forgive each other, not letting things go when we're supposed to let things go, if that's what we're doing, nothing's going to get done. God's not going to use us in the ways that he has. I truly believe that. In order to see this church grow, in order to see this youth group grow, you have to let God use you, okay? But we have to stay dedicated to each other. We have to stay focused on becoming stronger as a family, okay? And I know that sounds really corny, but we got to remember that. Quality over quantity. I don't care if there's 10 kids that show up on Wednesday nights. If those 10 kids are here committed to serving Christ and fellowshipping with each other, I'd rather have that than 120 kids who just don't care. Does anybody agree with me? I think that's really important. Thank you. We're going to start worship right now, and I hope we stay focused during worship and have fun. And